The Tennessee Aquarium, home to over 12,000 animals of a wide diversity, fish, mammals, reptiles, amphibians, birds, crustaceans, and more, all call it their home. Have you ever given any thought as to how these two buildings are maintained? The answer can be summed up with one word: bioremediation. Bioremediation is the use of organisms to remove pollutants from air, soil, or water. Large-scale aquariums like the Tennessee Aquarium use bioremediation in two steps. The fish and other aquatic organisms give off ammonia. The water is pumped through tens of miles of pipes, and the wastes are consumed by a bacteria called Nitrosomonas. These rod-shaped bacteria are rare in nature, but is used by the trillions to help break down the waste. These bacteria cells create their own waste, which is consumed by a second rod-shaped bacteria called Nitrobacter, to complete the second step. The seemingly simple process is vital to every animal calling the aquarium their home. Without these bacillus bacteria, the fish would suffocate in their own feces. In 2005, Hurricane Katrina devastated New Orleans. The staff of the Audubon Aquarium, located right off the mighty Mississippi, was evacuated, and just 4 days later, when they returned, they found all the fish that respirated through gills were dead and floating atop polluted water that flashlights could not penetrate more than a few inches. Only the air-breathing animals survived. Now that we have discussed the life-saving process involved, let's discuss some of the animals we see. Sharks are composed of mostly cartilage. They have special cells that detect electricity given off by all living animals. Thanks to electricity, the sharks are a near-perfect predator. Talk about a shocking trait! The piranhas shown here are attracted to shiny materials. When the quarter is flashed, they come to the glass and give an awkward stare. The catfish whiskers have chemoreceptors, which mean they taste whatever the whiskers touch. Imagine if someone's beard can do the same thing! Look at these jellyfish! They do not have blood, they do not have bones, and they do not have a central nervous system. These spectacular creatures survive by floating in currents in the oceans. These currents are duplicated in the exhibit. Without them, these jellies would sink to the bottom and disintegrate. Although these jellyfish look so adorable, don't let them get into your swim shorts. Their neophytes will form a really nasty sting, and you'll have a bad day at the beach. the octopus can defend itself by using ink, camouflage, or bite you. And the bite isn't very pleasant either. The cuttlefish's saliva contains neurotoxins that can really mess you up. So don't go out cuddling with the cuttlefish. We have had quite the adventure today. We learned how the aquarium keeps its tank clean by using living organisms like Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. We learned about the consequences of what happens when you do not keep the tanks clean, like Hurricane Katrina's incident. And we learned a few interesting facts about the animals. Now let's go back to the surface and enjoy some beautiful flowers on dry land.
I saw her sitting in the rain, raindrops falling on her. She didn't seem to care. She sat there and smiled at me. Then I knew,
I knew.
She could make me happy.
Happy. She could make me very happy.
Flowers in her hair. Smiled up at me. Then she took my hand and we walked through the park alone. Then
I knew.
She had made me happy.
Happy, happy. She had made me very happy.
And I was in her hair.
Why
she simply